Woo, did I have you jokers mad at me on Twitter yesterday? Well, YouTube too. Let's talk about this whole Jokic situation, why I said what I said about taking analytics or not taking analytics into account when debating who's better, this guy or this guy. Let's just talk about all of it. Let's clear the air. Social media. What's up, YouTube, and welcome back to the Sixers Break Room. If you're not already subscribed to the channel, stop wasting time. Just subscribe right now. Get it out the way. Cool. Now that we got out the way, don't forget to like the video. And of course, follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter. All of those are at Sixers Break Room. Now, I posted a YouTube short a day or two ago that came after a tweet that I sent a day or two ago where I was talking about Jokic and the use of analytics when making a claim that this guy is better than that guy. And of course, all of you got emotional about a guy that doesn't even know that you exist. And you came at me in my comment section talking about Jokic is clearly better than this guy, or that you know, I'm hating and he's better than Embiid. And I didn't even mention Embiid, but I guess, you know, since this is a Sixers channel, you guys assume that I believe Joel Embiid is better than Jokic, which I don't, but we'll get there in a second. But it had nothing to do with Embiid versus Jokic. As a matter of fact, it really wasn't about me thinking Jokic wasn't better than anybody in particular. What it was about is, when it comes to Jokic, every time I'm on social media, every time I see a debate about Nikola Jokic versus Giannis, Jokic versus Luka, Jokic versus Embiid, you guys throw out these analytics. These analytics, they seem to be the basis of your entire argument. And that is where I say there is a flaw. If your only argument is analytics, if your only argument is a bunch of statistics that weren't even around 5, 10, 15 years ago, well then, I don't really want to debate it. I don't want to have a conversation about it. I am not anti-analytics. I'm not a guy that believes that there is no use for analytics or that the numbers are stupid. Like, I'm not like that. Like, I remember Charles Barkley had his huge thing where he was like this anti-analytics guy. I'm not that. I believe analytics are a tool. I believe analytics are part of the equation, right? They paint part of the picture, not the entire mural. That's my issue. And usually when it comes to Jokic, people will talk about his true shooting percentage. They'll talk about his VORP, which I don't even know what VORP is, if I'm being honest with you, because it hasn't been around that long. I saw somebody talk about his LeBron rating. Oh, my dog just pushed the camera. My bad. His LeBron rating, which clearly hasn't been around that long because LeBron has only been around for the past 20 years. And I'm going to come out and say it. They probably didn't invent the stat his first 5 or 10 years in the league. So you have all of these. Hey, stop pushing. Dog, stop pushing the camera. Dog Nola pushing the camera. You got all of these analytics that haven't even been around that long, and you're trying to use them to say that's why he's better. If all you're doing is using analytics, you're probably not watching the games, right? You're probably not watching the basketball. Jokic is one of the three best players in the NBA, in my opinion, and I don't need to just use analytics to say that, right? He's 7 feet tall. He can handle the ball. He's the best passer in the NBA. He's able to start to break at 7 feet tall, which is huge because as a basketball player, if your big man can start to break, that allows your guards to run free. Like now you have Murray and Porter getting up the floor. Instead of having to bring the ball up, it relieves some pressure off of the guards. When he makes you pay, whenever you try to send a double to him, he's going to find the open guy. Even if he doesn't get the assist, he might get the hockey assist. He's able to shoot the ball at all three levels. He can score at the low post. He can score in the mid-range. He can knock down outside shots. Like, there is so much basketball that shows he's the best or one of the best players in the NBA. I don't need to just use analytics. I don't need to tell you his VORP to tell you why I think he's one of the best players in the NBA. You understand what I'm saying? Now, after I talk about his ball handling, his passing, his vision, his ability to knock down outside shots, his ability to score down low, how he's a mismatch nightmare, how he'll kill you for double teaming. After all of that, now I might talk about some analytics. Now I might talk about his true shooting percentage. Now I might talk about this stat or this stat or this stat. But before I'm even getting to the analytics, I can just talk basketball about why he's better than this guy or that guy. And that's all I'm saying. Some of you guys can't talk about the basketball, which is either A, because you're not actually watching and you're just looking at the box score and you're just looking at analytics and you're like, oh, he must be the best. or B, you lack basketball IQ and you're not able to communicate or you know, you're not able to talk about the basketball stuff and all you can do is read the numbers. Either way, I ain't mad at you. I ain't hating on you. I ain't even coming at you like that. I'm just saying I don't have time for the debate. You can debate with your friends. You can debate with your peers, whoever you want. You can go back and forth, this analytic, that analytic, this analytic, but just not with me. If all you have is analytics, cool. I mean, I ain't going to be mad at you. It's an opinion. This is sports. At the end of the day, it's all opinion. But I'm just not that interested in having a debate where all we're going to talk about is the numbers. Now, let's talk about Jokic versus Embiid because naturally being a Sixers channel, a lot of comments turn into, they made the assumption that they turn into Jokic versus Embiid. Well, guess what, guys? I think that Jokic is better than Embiid. I haven't always felt that way. A year or two, I would have told you that I felt like Joel Embiid was better. But I do believe Jokic is better. I believe Jokic is better because he's able to do more on the floor. I'm not going to say he like when it comes to your traditional center stuff, scoring on the low block, square up and face the basket, back to the basket, being able to do those things, rebound the basketball. I'm not going to say that Jokic does those things better than Embiid. I think physically, Joel Embiid's ability to oppose his will physically is better than that of Jokic. But Jokic can do more on the floor. Jokic is a much better passer than Embiid. I think that can't even be debated. Very often, Joel Embiid is forced to play at the high post because he's not a great passer out the double team on the low post. At least that's why I believe they're putting him at the high post. Whereas Jokic, it doesn't matter where you put him. If you send a double, he's finding the open guy and the Nuggets are going to get a layup. And more important than all of that, the best ability is availability. Jokic is available. Jokic doesn't get hurt in big playoff series. Jokic doesn't miss 5-10 games at a time like Embiid frequently does. Now, that's not all Joel Embiid's fault, but we got to call a spade a spade. He's injury prone. He misses games. And it's not just a regular season. We've seen him miss time in a postseason where that hasn't been the case for Jokic. That being said, do I think Jokic is the best player in the NBA? No. Because basketball is played on both ends of the floor. And as great as Jokic is offensively, he's not great defensively. And now this is where people might try to throw some analytics at me. Well, oh, look at this stat. It actually shows he's a better defender than people. I don't want to hear it. I watch basketball. He's not a great defender. He's just not, right? He's not great one-on-one defensively. He's not great in pick-and-roll defense. He's a solid help defender at best. He's a below average defender. So that's why when people say he's the best player in the NBA, I say, hold on now. Because if you just look at the production, well, Giannis, while nowhere near as skilled offensively as Jokic, produces offensively damn near similarly. He's scoring 30 plus a game. He's getting you 5 or 6 assists. This is a down year shooting, but typically he's going to be in the mid 50% from the free from the field, right? He produces on offense. And he's an A-plus defender. He can guard every single position. He's great in help defense. He could be a rim protector. He could be a perimeter defender. So when you talk about who the best player in the NBA is, I'm sorry, if you're only supremely great on one end of the floor and not so much the other, you're not a better basketball player than him. But that's just my opinion. That's my preference. Your preference might be that Jokic is better than Giannis. I ain't mad at you. But I am going to say I ain't got time for it if the only basis of your argument is analytics. I also prefer Luka over Jokic. Again, that is just a preference. I believe that what Luka is able to do offensively with the ball in his hands and all the attention that he draws, I think that is something that is, especially at his size at the position, I think that's something that is, you know, very unique. And I think that it's something that is unguardable. I think that when you come into these games, you're like, how can we stop Luka? We have to make sure we stop Luka. Whereas Jokic, I think the game plan is a little bit different because of his ability to find so many different guys. Again, I'm not saying that Luka is better than Jokic. I don't mean, like, and maybe I did say it, but I don't mean he's not better than Jokic. I just prefer Luka over Jokic. Again, if you say Jokic is better than Luka, if you say Jokic is better than Giannis, cool. But it can't just be analytics. You got to have some basketball IQ and some basketball explanations for why you feel that way. At least in my opinion. And that's just how I feel about it. That's what I meant with the tweets. That's what I meant with the YouTube short. That's it. Jokic is great. I think Jokic is one of the three best players in the NBA. I think Giannis is definitely better because of what he does on both ends. I think Jokic and Luka is more of a preference thing. And then after that, There's no one better than Jokic. Not in my opinion. But what do you guys think, man? Sound off in the comment section below, because y'all already blew up my Twitter. Y'all already blew up the YouTube short comments. So blow this one up too. Let me know, who do you think is the best player in the NBA and why? Let's just let that be the question. Who do you think is the best player in the NBA and why? Let me know below. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter. All are at Sixers Break Room. And I'm going to see you guys on the next video. Peace.